Hey guys, hope you're doing well. This is an HF transmitter I built earlier this month. It has two modes, AM and a CW beacon mode. The case here is an Altoids mint tin, sanded down, sprayed with primer, and painted with acrylic. And before you say anything, I'm not an artist, but I'm happy with the way it turned out. The construction of the transmitter is actually clever, and I got the tip from YouTuber VK3YE. He made a video last year about turning the Pixie transmitter into an AM transmitter. And what is the Pixie? Here's one that I built without modifying. It's a 1.2 watt CW transceiver kit that costs only $4 from eBay. It has a frequency range of 7023 to 7026 kHz, which is a good area of the band for QRP. You can swap out crystals, however, you would need to change some of the values of the components. In order to key this thing, I took a switch from a microwave oven door and connected it to an 1/8-inch phone jack. It's crude, but it works. So I followed the instructions of VK3YE, cutting traces, changing components, and jumping connections, and I was able to turn this CW transceiver into an AM transmitter. The output is around 300 milliwatts, which is good enough to be used with an RF amplifier that I have in the works. The main problem with this circuit is that it has horrible, 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 horrible harmonics. The second and third are especially bad. So I made this quick and dirty 7 MHz low pass filter, which provides around 25 dB of attenuation at 12 MHz. The current crystal I have in here is for 6.144 MHz. To get this thing to act as a beacon, I bought a cheap Arduino Nano clone and wrote some code to get it to pulse a Morse code signal out of pin 13. Then I triggered the transmitter's connection to ground with a transistor. So really, it's just turning the AM carrier signal on and off, but with no audio being transmitted, the carrier signal is relatively strong and acts as a CW signal. I did run into a problem with the larger value capacitors in the circuit, and I had to remove them because they were bleeding a charge after the circuit was shut off, causing the CW signal to sound more like a whining dog. Multi-PSK couldn't even make out the signal to be Morse code, but after that, it worked just fine. This whole design cost about $12 to build and took a weekend to put together. Not bad. So, to demonstrate this, I have a standard 12-volt wall power supply and a small dipole antenna totally not meant for 6 MHz, but it'll work for now. I'll set the transmitter to beacon mode and go upstairs to the ham shack, fire up the multi-PSK, and see what we can get.
So here's just a standard Texan radio, so we're just going to check to make sure it's showing up on here. Cool. Well, let's go upstairs.
All right, so this is my Kenwood TS450S, and it's hooked up to an antenna that is outside. I don't know if you can see that PVC pipe out by the fence. That PVC pipe is holding a dipole that's about 40 meters long, I want to say. It stretches pretty much the entire length of the backyard and then to the house. So, let's tune this to the frequency of the beacon. Cool. Now let's load up multi-PSK and see if we can decode it. Now, while this is loading up, the one thing I want to say is you're going to hear a little bit of frequency drift in the tone, and that is only because I am using a really poorly made Chinese wall wart to power this thing. So you're going to hear some 60 hertz hum as a side tone, and you're also going to hear a little bit of drift. When you're using a 12 volt battery, you get none of that drift and you get none of that chirping sound. And that's our signal right there. Let's focus in on this. I think that's our signal. We're going to have to really turn the audio down so that we can get a clean signal on this. Currently turning it down. And that seems like that should be good. And we are already on CW, as you can see up there. So let's see if this will decode. It's not doing a great job of decoding it on this radio, so I'm going to bring up my little Texan and we're going to see if we have any luck with that.
Well, my radio keeps dying here. And my phone camera is also out of space. But as you can see, what it's supposed to say is CZ101, 400 milliwatts, 6144 kilohertz, Somerset County, PA, which I was going to put it there. I don't know if I still am. The email, which I'm not going to show you, I'm going to blur that out, and then happy DXing. So it is, in fact, decoding, which is good to see.
So there you have it. If you stumble across one of my test transmissions, there will be a contact email within the beacon code. Feel free to send me a message, and I might send you some cool stuff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.